I'm Kakani Katija, a bioengineer with Mbari and the Monterey Bay Aquarium Research Institute.
Our team developed a new game called FathomVerse that invites casual gamers and enthusiasts to join us in our mission to discover all life in the ocean.
Welcome to the FathomVerse Hub. Game players of FathomVerse are contributing directly to ocean science by identifying animals and imagery collected by researchers all over the world. To start, why don't we adjust our soundscape and select the tone of our game experience by changing our ocean radio channel in settings. And in case you skip through all of the onboarding screens and forget how to play the game, you can click the tutorial. In order to play the game, the goal here is to look at brand new images and contribute to science. By clicking training, you can then enter your first interaction and start to learn about these animal missions. So here you can see three different animal missions. I've done one of three dives with cydipid comb jelly, two of three dives with a squid, and brittle star, which has a ribbon on it. And what that means is I've been certified. And to be certified, I have to do at least three dives. And once I'm certified though, that particular animal I can search for in expeditions. Let's get started with our training. And the way we do this is by selecting one of those slots and filling it by selecting another animal group. And what this does is it takes you to a library of currently 44 different animal groups that has different tiers that you can unlock as you are certified on them. When you click on the animal that you want to be trained on, what you'll see is a mission briefing, and mission briefings will contain a lot of different content and information. And we've also included a lot of images, images of representative animals that fit this particular group, but also images of confusing lookalikes with an explanation on how to tell them apart. But once you look at the entire mission briefing, you can then select that particular animal for training. By tapping the screen, you're sending a pulse out that will reveal different animals and their images. And so you can click on those images to make them full screen and then evaluate whether or not these particular animals match one of your active missions or is an animal that you would like to favorite. You then want to drag that image from, you know, the top of your screen to the avatar so that you can collect it. So here we have an animal that looks like a black coral. I'm zooming in and out by pinching, and then I pull that image down to the avatar for collecting. You'll also notice at the top, we've got the three icons that correspond to the animal missions that we have active and we're being trained on. You'll also notice there's a progression bar there that shows you how many images you've opened up and how many more you have available. Once you swim around on your currents, you also have the option to turn and go on other currents by selecting this turn button here. And that turn button becomes an option anytime you come up to an intersection of currents. You can leave the dive by clicking that top right button. And the very first thing you see is points. You're given contribution points based on here, how many animals you revealed. You also get a bonus if you reveal all the animals. After you go from that screen, you are now in the labeling screen. And so here you're trying to decide if this image either matches one of your active missions, and then you drag that animal name or group to the image. The other option you have is favoriting an image, and I do this by clicking that top right part, and that adds this animal to my favorites list that I can go back and view from the hub. But once I finish labeling everything, this is my first opportunity to get feedback. And so during training, I'm looking at images of animals that experts have already verified. And so my guesses or my labels are being evaluated against them. So here you see that the community agrees with me most of the time, but there is one particular image that the community says I got wrong. But say I disagree with what a FathomVerse says. Maybe I feel strongly that that black coral is a black coral instead of a sea pen. So I have an option to flag it by clicking on that image and selecting flag. And then that flagged image gets sent back to an operator of FathomVerse. And once I complete three dives, I am now certified for that particular animal. And by being certified, that means I can look for that animal and have an active mission in expeditions. An expedition allows us to look at images that haven't been viewed or labeled before. Similar to training, here you have to select 3 animal missions. You're only allowed to select animal missions, though, that you have been certified for, as indicated by that ribbon. And then I am selecting jellies here, and I've added them to my missions, and I click dive. And there are some big differences between training and expeditions. Primarily, you have more images, up to 50 images that you can look at. The images are a little bit more challenging. And then the other big difference is that in expeditions, it contains images that nobody has seen before or very few people have seen before, and they need to be labeled. So similar to the training dive, the same mechanics, I am pulsing or tapping my screen, revealing animals, making decisions around whether or not I want to collect them by dragging them onto my avatar or if I want to favorite them. But once I make sufficient progress or I, you know, view all of the animals in this dive, I can exit the dive by clicking that top right button. And then I'm assigned points based on my decisions around revealing animals. And then I go to the same labeling screen. But the big difference between expedition labeling and training labeling is that you have this other option. And when you drag that other label up to the image, what you can do is select an animal that you are already certified for. So it's really cool. It allows you to label more animals, not just your 3 active missions. So after you finish your labeling interaction, you get feedback on the images that we have labels for. You'll see the community agrees with me, also disagrees with me. There's clearly animals I missed. But what's new in expeditions is you'll see here, there is one image that is unknown to the community and that I'm among the first to see this particular animal. And this is exciting because this is an unlabeled image and my vote or my label is being contributed to the Fathomverse community. And so that is the first mini game called Pulse. The second mini game is called Illuminate. And again, selecting the same animals you might for expedition, but the big difference between Pulse and Illuminate is your agency. You have the ability to move in whatever direction you want by dragging and holding your finger on the screen. And then what you're doing is you're essentially moving a flashlight around in the screen, similar to how we do deep sea exploration and looking for animals. And then as your flashlight gets on the animal image, you can click or tap the screen to collect it. And like Pulse, the labeling interaction is the very same thing. So remember those images that you observed but hadn't been labeled yet and you were one of the first people to look at it? Well, you get alerted by the My New Discoveries button. To get feedback on those images once consensus has been reached by the Fathomverse community, and then displaying what the consensus is for the images that I looked at and evaluate how well I agreed with the consensus. And so you can see here, not only did I get a lot of agreement, but I still have about 73 more images that are still unknown to the community. Another really important piece to this is progression. Here you can see that you can either unlock awards in the form of videos or imagery or levels based on how many contribution points you receive. To open up those awards, you go to the vault, and here you can see a collection of your unlocked awards that are in the form of videos or images. Another feature that you can access from the hub is favorites. And so remember, during the labeling interactions, you have the option to favorite those images, and this is where you can see all of them, maybe even take a screen grab and share with your family and friends. Another thing you can access from the hub is the animal library. And so it's a quick access point to all of that content. And then last but not least is the community button. And this will take you to the Fathomverse Discord community. And here you can interact with other Fathomnauts and also learn how your contributions are improving our knowledge of ocean life. Onwards and downwards to explore more of the Fathomverse.